Video on modal auxiliaries, we saw the techniques of using all the modal auxiliaries, and we saw will, would, shall, should, can, could, may, might, must, need, ought to, etc. And in that we saw certain basic features of using the modal auxiliaries, and also we saw that what are the main verbs, how do main verbs function, and what are the primary auxiliaries, and what are the modal auxiliaries. And now we will see in detail some of the modal auxiliaries, their grammar and usage. So in today's video we are going to see how can we use can, could, may, might, must and ought to. These are really widely used modal auxiliaries, that's why I have taken this much today. So first let us see can. Can, when it comes in past tense, we use as could, and also when we are using reported speech, suppose she can come, it will automatically in reported speech can will become could, so she could come. So that is one way of transformation of can into could in reported speech, and also in past tense. Now I have very to make you understand this better, I have taken some sentences with can and similar meaning sentences in could also. You just observe now, we can climb to the top of the mountain, meaning possibility, this is ability. Ability, we saw in the previous video, can is used for expressing our ability. So we can climb to the top of the mountain. You see here, we could reach the top of the mountain yesterday. That means in the past tense, when we are using this can in the past tense, it becomes could here. You see, we could reach the top of the mountain yesterday. She can come. This is, it can be possibility as well as permission also. Oh, okay, she can come. Somebody is waiting for you outside, you can say she can come. She could come whenever she wanted to, that is also permission. A blanket permission has been given to her, whenever she wanted she could come. I can join the broken ends. See, I could join the broken ends. Now you have already joined the broken ends and you are showing to somebody. So that time you can use, see, I could join the broken ends. He can eat anything, this is also ability. He could eat anything before he was ill. The doctor said after he became ill that he can't eat certain things, but he could eat anything before he was ill. So we are expressing a past action. I can reach London, I can reach London. I could reach London last week, past tense. I can reach London, I can reach London by tomorrow, because it is possible that I can reach London. But here I could reach London last week, last week, that means he was able to reach London last week. My wife can leave the hospital, permission, the doctors have permitted my wife to leave the hospital, that means she can leave the hospital. My wife could leave the hospital a few days ago, my wife could leave the hospital a few days ago refers to the past one. We can sit in the garden, permission, we are permitted to sit in the garden. So here can refers to permission, we can sit in the garden. We could sit in the garden when it stopped raining, this is a kind of ability. Simon can shoot well, ability, Simon can shoot well. Simon could shoot well before his accident. Prior to his accident, he could shoot very well. Now he is not able to. She can pass her examination, ability. She can pass her examination. She could pass her examination in the last May, in last May. She could pass her exam last May, because this is a past one we are referring. Now we will see how may and might are used. May and might are used, I will give you more examples. Now we will see how we use may and might. May and might are normally used for expressing possibility. So here, see, perhaps Sonu is ill. Sonu may be ill. Listen to this sentence. Perhaps, maybe, possibility is there. Perhaps Sonu is ill. So Sonu may be ill. Perhaps we want to go out. We may go out. Perhaps it won't rain. It may rain. Perhaps it won't rain. It may not rain. So there is no possibility for it to rain. Perhaps we will buy a car. We may buy a car. Perhaps Anthony is not at home. Anthony may not be at home. So this is how. It may rain. He may come in the evening. I may pass the examination. I may receive him. I may leave him in the station. Possibility. These are all possibility. But when we use might, actually, you see, when we are not sure about some things, when we are not sure about some things, we use might. Karuna had a big lunch. She might not be hungry. You are presuming. You are presuming that she might not be hungry because she had a big lunch. The traffic is very heavy. So we might miss the train. We might miss the train because the traffic is very heavy. So we are not sure about the things. You may get the train also, but you are not sure of it. Where is Tina? She might be in the kitchen. There is a possibility. I am not sure where is she, but she might be in the kitchen. Where is your mother? Oh, she might have gone to market. She might have gone to hospital also. But you are thinking that it may be, she might be in the hospital. I might be here tomorrow. I might be here tomorrow. You are not sure. It is not surely telling. I will be here tomorrow. That is, there is an element of surety. But when you say I might be here tomorrow, that means you are not sure. It may happen or may not happen. That is the meaning. Now let us see the next one, use of must. Now let us see, there are two situations where must is used. Must, normally we say it as an obligation sometimes. I must help him. That means some internal obligation that I feel inside that I should do it. I must pray, internal obligation. I must help him, internal obligation. Other than that, must is used when we mean this is necessary. When we mean something is necessary, we use must. So that the usage of must also refers to necessity. So you see, I must get up early tomorrow because there is necessity for me to get up early tomorrow because I may have to catch a train. You must fill this form. If you want to apply for a job here, you must fill this form because that is necessity. You must write with pen. This is also a kind of compulsion that you must write with pen. That is necessity. You cannot write with a pencil. You must pay taxes. Again, it's necessity. You must pay taxes. The child must go to bed now. It is high time. Already it is so late. So the child must go to bed. So when we mean necessary, when we mean something is necessary or necessity, we use must. You see, second part. When we ask whether it is necessary, is this really necessary? That question also will be in must. Like, must I bring writing papers? Is it compulsory on my part to bring writing papers? Must I bring writing papers? Must I carry any money? Must I carry any money? Must I write in ink? Is it mandatory that I must write in ink? Must I answer every question? That means, is it necessary for me to answer every question? Must I come to his room? That means, must I come to his room to meet him or to take his permission or to console him, whatever it is. So we use must to mean necessary and also in a question form whether it is really necessary. Now we will see another one, that is ought to. I will give some examples. You see, where do we use ought to? To advise people. When we want to advise people something, including advising ourselves to do things. That means advising people, including ourselves, to do things. Obligation, which is not so strong as must. Auto is little less in degree compared to must. Those obligations which are not so strong as must, there we use ought to. So you see these sentences: what time I ought to arrive, what time I ought to arrive, I really ought to phone my mother, because you are feeling, again this is also kind of internal moral obligation on your part, moral obligation that you ought to phone your mother. People ought not to drive like that. People ought not to drive like that. People must not drive like that. That becomes a rule. If you say people ought not to drive like this, it is a self, they have to understand themselves that what they are doing is wrong. So self-realization. That is why advice to people. There ought to be traffic lights at this junction, because a lot of accidents are taking place there. So you say there ought to be some traffic lights, because you cannot compulsorily say that. I ought to visit my parents more often. You are unable to visit them, you are neglecting them. So you are telling yourself, advising yourself, that I ought to visit my parents more often. The builders ought to have finished by the end of this week. The builders ought to have finished the construction by the end of this week. People ought to be warned about swimming here, because a lot of accidents are taking place. So they ought to have been warned. You ought to have received the report by now. You ought to have received the report by now. They ought to have stopped at the traffic light. They should not. They did not do it. So there was an accident. They ought to have stopped at the traffic light. That was your advice, what you are thinking. So this is how, in grammar of modal auxiliaries, we should focus more on the meaning and usage, and appropriately and accurately we have to use can, could, may, might, must, and ought to. So these are the examples, and you can go through some more examples. You can work out from some standard grammar books, and most probably in the next video we will take up the reported speech. Thank you.